JaRoy Construction also had dealings with Jefferson Parish. We're joined now on the telephone by Councilman Chris Roberts out of Jefferson Parish. And Mr. Roberts, thanks for being with us this afternoon. What project did JaRoy bid on in Jefferson Parish?
Well, following Hurricane Katrina, we had the Tarrytown Gym, which had to be replaced because it was destroyed. And JaRoy was the low bidder on that project. It raised some questions and concerns for us early on because their price was a couple of million dollars less than the other bidders. But because of FEMA guidelines and state laws, we were forced to award them the contract.
So then what happened thereafter?
Well, we hired an attorney early on and started working with their bond insurers because the project was running behind. We were getting phone calls from subcontractors that were indicating that they were not getting paid. The project was set to be completed in November, and here we are today in February, and we're beyond that deadline, and we were trying to make a deadline for March, but the latest information that I have indicates the project won't get done until April. So it's a very unfortunate circumstance. You know, when companies like this come in and bid on projects knowing that they cannot complete them for the price that they're trying to bid in order to get the contract awarded, it places government and everyone else who relies on these public facilities in a very difficult position.
And no doubt affects future business and dealings with this company. Chris Roberts, thanks for being with us this afternoon. And by the way, WDSU News reporter Travers Mackle will join us live again at 6 o'clock with a full report on the arrest of JaRoy Construction President Jan Buras.